This video is sponsored by Squarespace, the best way to make an amazing website. There's recently been a dilemma in the MacBook Pro world. Do you buy the base 13-inch MacBook Pro for a crazy good deal right now? Or do you wait for the rumored 14-inch model that's supposed to come sometime next year? The answer to that question is different for each person and their specific use case, but in this video, I'll give you 5 reasons why you should buy the base 13-inch MacBook Pro right now. Reason number 1 is that it's currently on sale for a huge $200 off on B&H, and if you order right now before it goes out of stock again, you get free next day delivery, depending on your location. That's right, you can get a new 2019 MacBook Pro for the same retail price as the MacBook Air, which is an excellent deal. For reason number 2, there's a good chance that if Apple does release the 14-inch MacBook Pro next year, they may only update the higher-end $1,800 model and leave this base $1,300 model completely the same. Now, why would they do that? Well, in 2018, that's exactly what they did. They updated the $1,800 model to a quad-core processor, better graphics, and they gave it the touch bar, while keeping the $1,300 2017 model exactly the same for another year, with the old dual-core processor and older gen butterfly keys. But that's not the case with this base model that's currently on sale for $1,100. It actually gets a quad-core processor and graphics that's almost as powerful as the $1,800 model, and it blows it away in terms of performance per dollar. We actually recommend that most people do not buy the $1,800 model, but seriously just buy the base model because it's basically just as powerful. And if you take that into consideration, why would Apple upgrade both the $1,300 and $1,800 models to the new 14-inch display and better processors at the same time? Being Apple, it would make more sense to upgrade the higher-end 13-inch model first and keep the base model the same, because honestly, you're already getting a ton of performance for the price with the base model. So if that ends up happening, you'll be extremely disappointed if you waited close to another year for the 14-inch and you found out that you have to pay at least $1,800 to get it, instead of buying the base model right now for only $1,100. Now before we get into reason number 3, let me tell you about our sponsor, Squarespace. If you've been thinking about making your own website, Squarespace is seriously the best way to go. I built an engaging website for my wife's cleaning business with literally no web making experience. You just choose a template, customize blocks of text and images, and easily move them around. It's incredibly simple, affordable, and it's been running flawlessly for almost 2 years, bringing in new clients thanks to its built-in SEO tools. So whether you're making a website for a small business or for literally anything else, go to squarespace.com for a free trial and use our custom link below when you're ready to launch to save 10% on your first purchase of a website or domain. For reason number 3, this base model has the 4th generation butterfly keyboard. Now I know that makes you want to skip out on this model altogether, but you may not know that with this version of the butterfly keys, Apple replaced a few of the key materials with more reliable ones, and since the 2019 models, there has yet to be any reports of failed keys. Yes, the new Magic Keyboard on the 16-inch MacBook Pro feels a lot better, but the main reason that Apple has switched to those Magic Keys is because people don't trust the name Butterfly Keyboard anymore. So Apple had to completely ditch that name for people to feel more comfortable about purchasing a new MacBook. For reason number 4, the performance boost going from this model's 8th gen Intel CPU to the new 10th gen isn't that much. We've already had our hands on 2 Windows laptops that pack Intel's 10th gen processors, the Surface Laptop 3 with the lower end i5 CPU, and the XPS 13 2-in-1 with a slightly better i7 CPU. Looking at multi-core processing performance in Geekbench 5, the score only went up by around 400 to 800 points, depending on the chip. That's 10 to 20% more CPU performance, which honestly isn't that big of a deal if you have to wait a long time for the 14-inch. Now for graphics, we get a much bigger difference, from a score of 7358 up to 10,434, which is around a 40% boost in graphics performance. That's definitely a good reason to wait if you're a graphics user, but for those of you who don't do any kind of graphics work, there's no reason to wait. For reason number 5, technology is always moving forward, and yet there are people who wait for years and years because they keep hearing rumors of better and better MacBooks being worked on. The truth is, if you want a MacBook, you're gonna have to buy one sometime, and Apple will release a better model with better value eventually. My personal take on it is that instead of sitting around and waiting for 6 months, or maybe even close to a year, you can buy a MacBook Pro with excellent performance right now and enjoy it for all of those extra months that you would have been waiting. Those extra months of enjoyment are worth it, even if Apple releases a 14-inch MacBook Pro next year. And if they only update the higher-end $1,800 model to 14 inches, you'll be extremely happy that you got this base model for only $1,100. Now, if you disagree with me, go ahead and voice your opinion down below in the comments. But if you agree, we've got links in the video description below to this excellent deal on this MacBook Pro, so act fast before it goes out of stock. And if you're not already subscribed, click that circle above because we're starting our coverage of the Mac Pro tomorrow. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you tomorrow.